Well, how many of you remember the cartoon character Yosemite Sam? Notorious for riding that camel, calling it a mule, and say, whoa, mule, when I say whoa, I need whoa. Well, that's kind of what we need to do on this wagon. We need a little whoa. So I'm going to hook up the brakes this week. Well, last week we did get the wagon seat built for this camp cookie that's going to drive this wagon that feeds the cowboys on the trail. Well, he needs a place to put his feet so when he leans back on those set of lines, he's got something to brace himself against. So we're going to start with doing that. Then we need to make a brake handle and just what all makes this work. Now I've been able to scrounge a lot of old original irons for this wagon box. You remember the undercarriage is all original iron. There was no box, but I have been able to put together a bunch of old original irons. But I didn't find a brake handle or this pivot point that mounts to the side of the box for that. So I've got to fabricate something there and try to make it look like it's old. You know, our new iron is pretty square edged and it just doesn't look like the old original round edged iron. So when I'm making this brake handle, I'm going to take and round these corners off to give it kind of that old look of the old original irons. Now these brake handles need a little dog drawn out on one side that catches into this ratchet teeth, and there's a couple different ways you can do that. Back in my playlist of blacksmithing videos, I do show how this can be drawn out, but I'm going to do this similar to what I did on the borax wagons, and it'll have a removable little clip that can, as it wears out, it can be replaced. That's the style I'm going to put on this wagon. So when we're dealing with mechanical brakes like what is on this wagon, we are dealing with a ratio aspect of mechanical advantage. Now the overall length of this handle is 40 inches, and from the attachment point of the rod that goes back to the rear brake roller to the point that it attaches to the wagon is 8 inches. So above this point we have 32 inches, so we have a 4-to-1 mechanical advantage in the brake handle alone. Well, this rod then just goes back to the brake roller, which is 20 inches tall, which goes down to the metal tab that attaches to the brake beam, which is only 5 inches long. So there, once again, we have a 4-to-1 advantage. So we have a 4-to-1 on top of a 4-to-1, which gives us a 16-to-1 advantage from the brake handle to the brake blocks that rub up against the tires on the wheels. So if we put 10 pounds of pressure on the brake handle, we are actually exerting 160 pounds pressure against the face of the tire. Well, we're gaining ground on this chuck wagon. I've got a couple toolboxes to make. I might make a platform or for a water barrel if he wants to add one down the road. And I've got to sew a canvas top for this. So we might be winding this up pretty soon. Once again, thanks for watching.